Emo children, it's your emo daddy, Sean.
And Riley.
That's right. We're back with another react, and we have Bring Me the Horizon back on. Dropping some new heat. Looks like it was a couple days ago. We're excited to check that out.
Yeah.
If you want to check out our music, we got a 5-song EP out called Novellas. That's right. You can stream it on all the major streaming platforms, or head into the description of the video. There's a link to our merch store.
Yep.
Real quick, we want to give it a shout out to our sponsors, Ghost Killer Entertainment and Solar Guitars, as well as
Collision Drumsticks.
Wapa!
Boom.
Let's do this.
All right. DiE4u by Bring Me the Horizon, one of my favorite bands.
You know that I died for, I cried for, you know that I died for you. You know that I grieve for, I bleed for, you know that I grieve for you.
Not a fan of the auto-tune.
Let me see my halo, even though it's painful, I'm prepared to lose. You know that I die for, I'd cry for, you know that I die for.
Yeah! I like this part.
Yeah. First part was very Post Malone.
Yeah.
Not a fan.
Yeah.
Not that I hate Post Malone, but I don't like it for them.
Speaking of Post Malone, isn't this his melody line right here?
Sounds very familiar.
What's that song you
love?
Yeah. It's like the double time there, that's cool.
Yeah, I don't mind this at all. Definitely prefer this feel.
Yeah. Cool video.
Yeah. It's definitely catchy.
Yeah.
This isn't love. This is a car crash. This isn't love. This is a bloodbath. This isn't love. This is a sentence. It's a bullet in the head. This isn't love. This is a car crash. This isn't love.
How they layered that scream on the singing at the end there. That was cool.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm going to get a bunch of shit, but I just, I don't know. I like songs like Mother Tongue and Follow You, and I like when they go lighter.
Right.
I do. But for me, it's like, you know, the Royal Albert Hall type shit. That's the spirit, Sempiternal.
Yeah.
There is a Hell. That's my favorite era. I don't really like pop music, so I think maybe that's my issue.
Yeah, it definitely feels 100% pop. Like you were saying, Post Malone, I fall apart.
Yeah.
Especially for that section there. I mean, it's almost identical as far as the melody line.
Yeah.
You know, and like I said, I love these guys. I'm not a fan of the overuse of the auto-tune. I understand that, you know, maybe they want it for the vibe of the song or whatever. Yeah. But when you know that a vocalist is so good as Ollie, and you know that he doesn't need that.
Yeah, he's incredible.
Yeah, just it kind of takes away from the song for me. You know, I really dug the song, especially the hook. You know, it's really catchy. But that first part was really hard for me to kind of see past.
Yeah, it kind of, I don't know, to me, I like pretty much everything they've ever done. Like I said, I have my favorites mm-hmm. by them. But when I put this next to a song that's a little more similar, like Follow You or, you know, Mother Tongue.
Right.
Those songs seemed a lot more passionate.
Yeah.
And seemed a lot more well thought out. This kind of, to me, was just, it just sounds like, let's rush and put something out.
Yeah.
That's really catchy and people will like it.
Right.
And that's cool. I mean, I still would listen to this over anything on the radio personally.
Right.
But judging this based off previous Bring Me the Horizon stuff,
right.
It's a miss for me. But I think if this was a different band, I would have liked it more.
Right.
If that makes sense. Like hearing them do this, I think is a big part of why I don't like it.
Yeah, I mean, they've really set the bar so high for themselves.
Yeah.
You know, Sleepwalking, Avalanche, a bunch of other great songs out there that are just, they're super deep. And like this one, it's got a great message, obviously, but it's just, I don't know, it's too pop rock for me, I guess I could say.
I would you know. Agree.
Yeah.
But that said, I mean, if someone like a Youngblood or any of the litany, I don't know if that's the proper word to use there, any of the many artists that are doing that, like, you know, new punky,
right,
poppy, rappy thing.
Yeah.
If any of them put this out, I would have been stoked on it.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. It's almost like, you know, it would fit them a little bit better. You know, and the things that Bring Me the Horizon has put out before, I mean, they have such a core meaning to the things that I listen to.
Yeah.
It's really hard. You know, this is like a party track to me, which I can appreciate. And I feel like it'll bridge the gap for a lot of people. You know, they'll check this song out and then go check out other Bring Me the Horizon.
Sure.
But for me, it's just not the strongest track that they put out.
Yeah, I don't hate it. I just don't think it's that great for a Bring Me the Horizon song.
Yeah. And I honestly feel like a lot of that I would feel differently if there wasn't so much fucking auto-tune in the beginning.
Yeah, that it does bother me too. I mean, it's been a trend for a really long time.
Yeah.
It'd be cool if it kind of started going away a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel like it is. I mean, and I feel like it is starting to go away a little bit. I feel like if this would have come out, you know, beginning of 2020, maybe I would have received a little bit different. But now I'm ready for the raw that's coming back right now.
Yeah, I would agree. Yeah. Especially from a band as talented as this.
Exactly. That's my main gripe, is this band is so great in what they do. You know, I feel like this was kind of a B-side track, which there's nothing wrong with that, but you know, that's just my honest opinion.
I would totally agree, you know, and like we always say, we're not going to bullshit you. If we don't like something, we're not going to say we like it.
Yeah, and I mean, this is one of our favorite bands, so.
Yeah, this is a band we love. In fact, I mean, we're playing a cover show as Bring Me the Horizon. We like them that much.
Yeah.
And side note, if you're in the Boise area, December 12th.
Yeah, baby.
We will be playing a set as Bring Me the Horizon.
I think it's the 11th.
The 11th, my bad.
That's
okay. You should come check it out. But yeah, this is one of my personal favorite bands. This doesn't do it for me.
Well, it's just like the Ice Nine Kills song that we just did. It's not a bad song. It's just not the strongest song in my opinion.
Yeah.
You know, so. But there's nothing wrong with a band setting their bar so high that they got to really push themselves.
Yeah, I think you were spot on with that they've just set the bar way too high for me.
Yeah.
And so now I expect every track to live up to it.
Yeah.
And realistically, with no band, is that ever going to happen?
100%.
But yeah. I can't help it.
Yeah.
After I watched that Royal Albert Hall show, it's like, that's what I want.
Yeah, I want the chills. You know?
Right, but there are millions of other fans who want something more like this. So I get it. But yeah, just for me personally, not really my vibe.
Yeah. We did appreciate it, though. Bring Me the Horizon. You guys are always doing great stuff.
Yeah.
Check out our music. We got a 5-song EP out called Novellas. You can stream it all over the place. Actually, all the music that you hear while we're talking, that's actually from the EP. We worked really hard on it, so if you check it out, we really appreciate that a lot.
Yep.
Make sure you head into the description of the video. There's a link to our merch store.
Yep.
Hit subscribe and tap that bell. Ding, ding. That way you know when we upload the freshness.
And follow your emo daddies on Twitch, baby.
Yep.
We just did a fat live stream on this Sunday with Maddie Daddy. We got the three emo daddies.
Yep.
And we get to all the songs that we can't really get to on the YouTube, so it really helps us out a lot.
Yeah, we like checking out your guys' bands and, you know, just having some fun on there, hanging out. We do some video gaming, go behind the scenes and show audio production, and music writing and all that stuff. So if that's something you're interested, you can go check us out at Spirits Band on Twitch.
That's right. And as always, welcome
to
the
Spirit
World!